I'm Wendy Wilson, and I'd like to welcome you to another edition of Realizing Potential. Today I have with me one of my favorite colleagues and sorority sister and dear friend. I could go on, but I'm always excited about the role that she has on a continuum and what she does so well for Albany State University. She's one of those individuals that's really on the front lines and engaging and introducing Albany State University to prospective Rams, and then certainly when they make that transition into the wonderful world of being a Ram here at Albany State University. But she is here to discuss the week of welcome, and she is none other than Dr. Maria Lumpkin. How are you?
Thank you. I am well.
Good.
Thank you. It's so good to be in your company again.
It's always a pleasure to have you, certainly in the studio, and for you and I to catch up and chat, and you keep me enlightened in terms of what's going on with our prospective students, getting them through the doors successfully. And you have been extended what I think is a wonderful opportunity to set that initial engagement with our students.
Oh,
and
yeah.
So what happens during those initial first days, that first introduction, is certainly telling of what their overall experience will be like. And
absolutely.
So they have the right woman at the helm, Dr. Lumpkin. So one of the ways in which you do that is with the week of welcome.
Yes. So first of all, let me say that we have an unprecedented number of first-year students that are coming.
Excellent.
Throughout the summer, we have what we call new student orientation. And with new student orientation this year, we've had over 1,800 students to come through our new student orientation
wow.
program. And the extension of new student orientation is what we call Weekend of Welcome.
Mm-hmm.
And Weekend of Welcome is going to be August 8th through the 12th.
Okay.
And it will be an exciting time
yes.
for us to really induct our newest Rams into our academic community and showcase not only the vibrancy of our community, but also showcase the city of Albany,
mm-hmm.
Give them the tools and the resources that they're going to need to navigate their matriculation process here at Albany State University, both academically, socially, physically, spiritually, emotionally.
Sure.
We're going to touch on all of those wellness wheel opportunities so that we can start to shape our students into the holistic and productive individuals that we want them to be.
Indeed. It really is an encompassing, a mm-hmm. holistic and an enriching experience for them. And the way you set the tone, again, will play a huge role in how they continue to progress and certainly matriculate throughout the institution. So I was fortunate enough to have an opportunity to look at the program yesterday and was elated to see the various components and the experiences that the students will have, and that will be their first, again, their initial introduction, setting the foundation for them to move forward.
Absolutely.
And one of the things that really interests me is, again, as you mentioned, all of those key areas. They will experience that within a short, compact time frame, but I know it will then allow them to then walk away with something that is so memorable. And I have had the fortunate opportunity to see students, and I know you have, at other institutions that you've supported and contributed to, Morehouse and then Spelman, and then I know Hampton comes to mind as well. And they have such beautiful new student orientation
oh, yeah.
opportunities for their students. And I've heard alums years past their graduation date, they remember that initial
oh, yeah.
engagement and introduction.
Yeah. So the Weekend of Welcome is going to kick off, of course. Our housing move-in is going to be facilitated by a cadre of volunteers,
okay.
faculty, staff, student leaders. and our external community that are going to give our new students a blue and gold carpet experience as they move into their residential community,
yes.
where we know a lot of things happen and a lot of opportunities for co-curricular engagement mm-hmm. happens in our residential community or our living and learning communities. But one of the first activities beyond them moving into their residential communities is our induction ceremony. And being inducted into this community is going to be so exciting for our students.
Yes.
And that is coupled with our parent parting ceremony. So we want to establish some very rich traditions for our students. They'll come in their continuous white, and they will be pinned with the official class of 2022 pin. And what we want to crystallize to them is that their destination is graduation.
Yes.
And their graduation date is May 7th, 2022. And we are excited that we will have faculty and staff and student leaders to create a gauntlet by which they will process into and they will recess out of the facility to our founder and visionary's grave and pay homage to him. And that is going to be such a moving moment for them.
Yes.
It's going to be an opportunity for them to really, really connect with the enduring mission of our institution and really establish some institutional pride
sure.
on the very first day that they come to our campus.
Yes.
The magic of the first 6 weeks of school when you have new students coming in is when you have the best opportunity
yes.
to captivate them, to help them to embrace what it means to be a part of an academic community, to start to get their wheels turning in terms of them being a part of an intellectual environment.
Sure.
And they're going to have fun too.
Good.
You know, they're going to have Ram Cinema, they're going to have Ram Olympics.
Okay.
They're going to have a pool party and a blue and gold cookout with a showcase of our Greek organizations on campus. But also on Saturday, we're going to be engaged in some community service projects and introducing them to the ideals of service learning and community service and volunteerism. We're going to take them on a tour of our wonderful city of Albany, where they're going to be introduced to some points of interest downtown. We have on our campus, we're very fortunate to have a great relationship with the city of Albany, where we have a transportation system that we call the Ram Rush.
Yes.
So students will be able to experience getting on the Ram Rush for the first time and learning how to navigate the city and between our two beautiful campuses. Independence is important as they transition from being high school students into a collegiate community.
Sure.
And so those are a few of the things that we're going to be doing. Also, we are introducing our students to global citizenry.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to have a Global Citizens Cafe where we're going to introduce them to opportunities for service abroad, education abroad and study abroad opportunities. And we're going to have coffee and tea from around the world. And some of our international students are going to talk to our students about their experiences being in our community. And we'll have our director of the Office of International Programs to talk about the various opportunities that we have for our students to really engage in the international diaspora. So we're really, really excited that it's a very comprehensive program.
It sounds like it.
Yes. And we know that students will have business that they still need to take
sure.
care of before we start school on Monday. But this is really a preview. It's like a zero day for them,
mm-hmm.
for them to kind of connect with our community, with the resources that we have, and also with our cadre of wonderful student orientation leaders that have been working really diligently all summer long to prepare this wonderful weekend of welcome activity for them.
Outstanding. Well, one of the things I was most impressed with when I had an opportunity to learn of just how extensive the weekend will be for those students is that it will then it mirrors so much of what the world they will be introduced to once they graduate.
Mm-hmm.
That 2020 no,
2022,
that date. And once they embark upon that journey, because it is very complex. And so if we can start as early as possible that indoctrination process that you have your foot in so many different areas, that you need to be well-rounded, that you need to be able to engage and interact at various levels. There is, it is important to your own personal development and that you, as you say, be a global citizen, that you understand the importance of giving back. So coming to this institution is not just about learning the core and mastering your discipline that mm-hmm. will then allow you to embark upon whatever career path that you want. It is indeed very complex. And
yes.
So the development of soft skills, learning to become a part of a rich legacy, your role in that process, and then carrying on that tradition.
Mm-hmm.
So you thought of everything.
Yeah, it's, and your session, I'm so excited. I'm going to be the first person there.
Oh, well, thank you.
Your session on being a brand ambassador.
It is so critical.
You know, we want people, when they interact and engage with Albany State University students, we want to be very clear about the product that we put out. And so you will set the tone for that. And we want our students to be very astute, and we want them to be dispatched into this world and be recognizable as our product. And
so
it's important for us to make sure that they have the tools and the resources to position themselves to be the ambassadors that we want them to be.
Sure.
And we know that college, being in college is a process that transforms you, or at least it should.
Indeed.
And we want them to be transformed by the education that we provide for them at Albany State University.
Absolutely.
And so when they come in as first year students, they come in eager to learn and they're excited. But when they leave, my goal is that they are unrecognizable because they have been so changed by what we have to offer. When they walk across the stage, I want them to be very different than when they came in 2018.
It is. And I love that you take that approach. It is very genuine and sincere. But we need to be very clear and honest. It is a very awesome responsibility that is that lies at your feet.
Mm-hmm.
Because again, the key word is that we are intentionally working to transform lives. Students come to us from a myriad of diverse backgrounds and experiences. Some at the very basic level, some very advanced. And so we have to be able to meet them where they are, and then with the ultimate goal, presenting to the world global change agents.
That's right.
Who are able, as you use the word, dispatch to dispatch and then transform and make a huge difference. We all have that level of responsibility.
Absolutely.
So when parents send them to us.
Yeah. And every student's story matters. The unique thing about the work that we do in the Office of New Student Success Programs and Strategic Retention Initiatives is we have a responsibility to understand the science of every student's story that comes here. And that story could be that they're a first-generation college student.
Yes.
That story could be that they come with enumerated learning support needs. That story could be that they are coming from a background where they have they come to us academically prepared and advanced, and we need to support them in that realm. They could be an international student.
Mm-hmm.
They could be a student that, you know, is barely, you know, making it because they may have been coming from our foster system.
Mm-hmm.
They may come as a legacy student to our institution. There are a variety of ways that students choose our institution, but understanding the science of every student's story and understanding that there is a blanket of support that we have to provide for every single student is essentially important to our job. And so we get to see that, you know, before they come in with predictive analytics. We are understanding more about the students that we have. when they come to us and they get derailed in their first year, we're able to do some intrusive advising and support them with the resources that we have through our tutoring program, through the programs that we have, through our Title III program structure, through our Academic Advising Center, through our supportive faculty and staff members that go be above and beyond to support our students.
Right.
So understanding, again, the science of every student's story, and understanding that if they do get off track in any way, that we're providing the early intervention such that we can create that blanket of support is
sure.
essential to their success.
It is. It is. And you're absolutely right. I was reminded of a story that I've often told, and we see the full gamut in terms of students and their experiences and their backgrounds.
Mm-hmm.
So I've engaged and worked with students who are third generation
mm-hmm.
Albany State students, parents, grandparents, and then so forth. And so they understand the expectations, they understand how to access resources, they understand the importance of academic decisions that are made early on and
yes.
how that it is easier to progress. But then if there are deficits or deficiencies that impact your GPA early on, how are you going to correct that, and how that has a ripple effect. So they get that full understanding early on. And then you have that student who is literally a blank slate.
Mm-hmm.
They have no understanding, no concept, and that is okay.
Mm-hmm.
That is okay, but we need to be able to work with them. So as an example, I'm the executive director, as you know, of the Cordele Center, and I tell this story just to get so that people can have a full understanding of the individuals that walk through your doors.
Mm-hmm.
So student very excited and eager to enroll into Albany State, and of course wanted to take classes at the center. And so he walked in, he looked at the placard on the wall, and he said, "Is Mrs. Dean in?" And I said, "You know, we don't have a Mrs. Dean, but may I assist you?" And he says, "Oh, they told me to come and see the person that could help me get enrolled in school." And I looked and I saw that was Mrs. Dean. Now, what he didn't understand is that was not the last name of the person who occupied that space
mm-hmm.
in that office, but
the
actually
world.
The title.
Right.
Right.
Mm.
Yeah. So, and that I was kind of stunned, but,
yes.
but we work in our higher ed silo and
mm-hmm.
assume that everybody understands the jargon and the language that is
mm-hmm.
Applicable to that arena, and they simply do not. And so after continued dialogue, you understood that he would need a little more attention.
Absolutely.
But at the end of the day, he still had that level of excitement
yeah.
that third generation student
right.
that I encountered
mm-hmm.
had, and
mm-hmm.
that passion to learn. So we have to meet them
where they are. Right.
And
the beautiful thing about Albany State University is that there, we don't look at students as obstacles, we look at them as opportunities.
Yes.
And nobody operates from a deficit premise, regardless
sure.
of wherever you are coming from, or however
mm-hmm.
it is that you come to. It really doesn't matter how you arrive at our institution.
Right.
Again, it's all about the transformation that occurs once you're in our institution.
Absolutely.
And so that's the exciting thing about the work that we do,
yeah.
and the exciting thing about the mission that we have to provide educational access to all students
yes.
that want an opportunity to get an education
yes.
here in South Georgia. So.
Well, one of the things that I've observed about you is that you approach each of those situations, particularly your new student orientations.
Mm-hmm.
And when you're meeting with students and you're meeting with the parents, all of those key stakeholders that play an instrumental role in that student's life, is that you approach it as it is a privilege, or we view you as a privilege, that you have chosen Albany State University. We
yes.
do not take that lightly.
At
we know
all.
That you have countless options.
Mm-hmm.
Competition is intense as it relates to higher ed. And so we are honored that you selected this institution
Absolutely.
To embark upon your continued educational, or begin your
educational
journey.
Yeah.
journey.
Absolutely.
Absolutely. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And so we, again, it's our esteemed honor that you. And so I love that. Everyone wants to feel special.
Absolutely.
These people are investing, have decided or selected this institution, Albany State University, and there's a level of trust that they've placed in us. And I could go on and on and on, but you make that known early on in the interaction, and I think that is so, so important.
Yeah. Educational choice, you know, it is a very competitive business, you know, here, and students can go anywhere.
That's right.
You know, but when they choose us, we have to adhere to our responsibility to shape the student's experience and our engagement with them with care. Mm-hmm. And that starts from application and it ends at graduation.
Yes.
And beyond, even when they become alums of our institution.
Sure.
So I do take that role very,
you
very
do.
Seriously.
You do.
And it's a very comprehensive role. It's not, my office does not facilitate new student orientation as an office. We work across the curriculum, across a variety of offices. It's highly collaborative work because it truly does take a village to ensure that our students get to May 7th, 2022.
Yes.
And that means that I'm constantly on the phone with different people, different stakeholders, trying to figure out how we can create the best possible scenario for student success for our students that are coming into our community.
Indeed.
And how we can facilitate that and be resourceful and be mindful of, again, their stories that they come to us with.
I think that's critical. Mm-hmm. That is, and we've seen once institutions have embraced that and then begin applying that, retention improves, and certainly your graduation numbers.
Yeah,
and that is why we are there. It's not just to get them through the door. Mm-hmm. We want them to be successful. Mm-hmm. That impacts, again, back to the workshop that I'll be facilitating, not only the individual's brand, but the institution's brand. Because,
right.
Again, we want it to be a continuum. We want students to continue to come year after. Mm-hmm. So we want it to be a 2022, 2023, 2024.
Mm-hmm.
And so with that comes an awesome responsibility. So where you do identify deficits, deficiencies, and areas in which you can improve, you must be intentional in trying to correct those.
Absolutely,
it's
absolutely.
Critical.
One of the things I do a session during new student orientation for the parents on parenting a college student, and one of the things that I emphasize with our parents is helping to develop a sense of independence.
Yes.
By letting their students go and allowing them to solve their own problems, because research, of course, shows us that students that are coming to college, that are gaining that sense of independence, do better than students that are coddled and students that are guided by their parents in ways that disrupt their ability
yes.
to do and solve their own problems. And I have a portion of my session where I talk about these are the phases that the students are going to go through.
Mm-hmm.
In the fall semester, they're going to be excited to come. They're going to have new friendships that they gain and new relationships that they gain. By the end of the first semester, there's going to be some anxiety. They're going to, you know, be thinking about, you know, whether or not I made the right choice.
Sure.
Do I want to come back the next semester? And all of those kinds of things. But when they have those conversations with students over the dinner table or wherever over the holidays, I said they should be talking a little differently.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they should be talking about what's happening with children and families at the border. They should be talking about the Supreme Court decisions
mm-hmm.
that are being made. They should be developing a level of empathy. That's how we know that our students are truly being educated.
Yes.
Not just to get a degree, but they're being educated so that they can be productive people.
Absolutely.
And at Albany State University, the degree is important, but the education is more important. The deepening of the educational process such that students begin to use their education in profound ways to redeem social conditions,
sure,
to be civically engaged, to be mindful of the role that they play in the career exploration process that they're going to be exploring during new student orientation, where they're identifying potential employment and career opportunities. They're going to be connecting with the things that they're learning in the classroom with the service to humanity. And that, to me, is what real education is all about. And that's a part of the mission of this institution, is that we're preparing productive citizens for the world.
Sure.
And we're preparing them, and we're helping them to use their education in profound ways.
Absolutely. And then it goes back to the core and the founding principles of the institution mm-hmm. itself, and Dr. Holly and, mm-hmm. and his assessment of this area mm-hmm. and the needs were, and the void that existed within the lives of people who were denied,
mm-hmm.
but still recognizing in them that they too can be change agents, and
Absolutely.
Having the foresight and the vision that they may not be able to do it to the magnitude because of the liberties that we have today
right.
and opportunities that we have today, but still having the foresight to pursue that. And here we are. And so, again, it goes back to that you are a part of that rich legacy, and you have a responsibility to give back. Of course, how many times have we heard stories, and there are many adages about it, about once you are given an education, that is the one very thing that no one can take away from
right.
you. But it certainly does not cease. It, again, is a continuum, and you have to develop that.
Right.
One of the things that I've been hearing constantly as of late is the intentional approach that the administration and the faculty and staff are now taking as it relates to, we owe you more than just the mastery of your particular discipline. There's some soft skills
right.
that you must also master, because then that will then help you to navigate open doors
mm-hmm.
and the development of critical thinking. So again, that holistic approach
mm-hmm.
that you mentioned, that is so comprehensive that they will receive in a couple weeks.
Absolutely.
How many students are you anticipating that weekend?
So I am told from our stakeholders meeting yesterday that we are anticipating having about 2,000 first year students to move into our residential community.
Mm.
Now we do have some students that are first year students that will not live on campus, but
okay.
upwards of about 2,000 students will be a part of this class. So
yeah.
we are so excited.
Yes.
We are elated again that so many students have chosen Albany State University
yes.
for their destination and educational journey.
Sure.
And we're just excited that that we have this opportunity to edify our students with the offerings of our Weekend of Welcome program, and with the support structures that our office and many other offices on this campus offers to students that are transitioning into college.
It really is. It really is. We really are privileged when a student then just decides that this is where I want to advance my overall development.
Mm-hmm.
Explain to the viewers, because I'm sure we may have some parents or someone that's out there. Hopefully they're involved, and if they're not, if they're relying on their student who is still trying to or in their independent moment, who may not have communicated that. So what is the registration process like for the Weekend of Welcome? Is it automatically done because you're a student? How does that notification or communique go to the students?
So all new students, when they receive their acceptance letter,
okay.
In their acceptance letter, there is a registration link to new student orientation.
Mm-hmm.
And we've had 8 new student orientations throughout the summer. The last one is on August the 8th, which is the start date of Weekend of Welcome. Weekend of Welcome is an extension of new student orientation that is the overnight portion that leads into the first day of classes. And so during the one day new student orientation, they come to campus and take care of the fundamental business of being a new student, but Weekend of Welcome is really a preview and an introduction to the resources and introduction to some of those core things that are a part of the wellness model that we deploy to assist students in becoming holistic individuals and having a well-rounded collegiate experience here on our campus.
Oh, great.
So,
well, I'm excited about that weekend, certainly honored to play a small role in that. And again, just elated for the students that will come before you and have an opportunity to experience you up close and at a distance. I know you will still engage with them.
Yes.
And avail yourself as you always do, but always excited. And your presence here at Albany State is, it seems like you've been here forever because you've had such a positive impact, but I know it's, you haven't even hit your 1 year mark.
No.
Yeah.
Wow. September 5th will be 1 year for me, or September 1st rather will be 1 year
yeah,
for me.
Yeah, so you, what you do is you raise the bar for those that follow. So your reputation gets out there, like she was able to accomplish this in this short period of time. So now here's the model. You need to go and replicate that in your particular lane.
Oh, thank
but
you,
yeah,
thank
we are
you.
Very fortunate to have you. And again, I'm very excited for those 2,000 students that will have an opportunity to take advantage of the Weekend of Welcome,
yes.
because as you likened it to, it will be that of a Ritz-Carlton experience.
Oh, yes.
And I was like, oh, if I could be a freshman all over
yes,
again just to
we
do Weekend of Welcome.
Their every need, and it's going to be a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful
Good.
Program. And the Weekend of Welcome schedule will be published online. There'll be a banner that will be up next week.
Outstanding.
We don't want to give out too much too soon,
right.
but it will be a banner that's on the web, you know, just in case students want to go on, or parents or other members of the support structure,
sure.
you know, for our students want to go on to see what's on. But the most important thing for all of our community, internal, external, family members, and certainly the class of 2022 is our induction ceremony mm-hmm. And parting ceremony, which will be on August 8th at 6 p.m. on the East Campus in Hyper Gymnasium. We are so excited that that will be the focal point of their entrance into this
yes.
wonderful community. And the details about attire for that occasion will also be published online.
Outstanding. So we want to certainly encourage those incoming students, those RAMs, future RAMs, and their parents to take a look at that so
Absolutely.
That they can get an idea of what that's about.
Yes.
Always excited to have you on the show,
it's
Dr.
Always
Lumpkin.
Wonderful to be here with
My
you,
pleasure.
Dr. Wilson.
My
and
pleasure.
Thank you for everything that you do
thank you.
In support of our mission and our goals here at Albany State, and thank you for being a part of the Weekend of Welcome committee.
Honored to do so. Thank you again. Viewers, thank you so much for joining me for this edition of Realizing Potential. I'm Wendy Wilson, and I will see you next time.